Here's a better view of what I meant by like a stud with a nut actually welded to it, and the stud beyond for the bracket. So there you go, those two are off. Pop, off it goes. And I can already see where it's been leaking through. So that's pretty crap. Get a nice new one. Now, what you're going to want to do, I didn't think of it earlier. I'm pretty sure, yeah, the new one doesn't come with it. There's little rubber gaskets in here. You're going to want to take them off, clean them. If they're no good, get some new ones. But these ones look alright, so I think I lucked out. Those are where the sensors were. So pull those out, clean them up, and put them in your new one. To pop those O-rings out, I just put my finger in there. Sure, I won't do it while it's one. Put your finger in there and they'll come right out. Clean them all up. And get them ready to go back in. Make sure you clean this surface really well. Give it a little scraper. Scrape off anything until that's nice and smooth. Okay? Because there'll be little bits of crud and crap around there. So a little, I don't know what you call them. I always draw a blank when I'm trying to do a video. My brain goes a million miles a minute. Yeah, just like a paint scraper or something, you know? And just scrape all that clean. This is going to look awkward because I'm doing it with my left hand. But when you're scraping on top, always scrape away from the hole when you're at the bottom, because you don't want to get debris in your motor. And when you're scraping the top, shove a rag in there so you can scrape, and then you won't have to worry about getting any debris in there. Okay? So that's what I'm going to be doing in the meantime. And remember, this seal will only be as good as you've cleaned it. If you've left debris behind to interfere with the gasket seal, you're going to have to do it all over again. So after I scraped things, I took a little emery cloth and I also went around it. So now she's nice and smooth. I don't have to worry. And neither will you. Okay, clean up those O-rings. I put them in. Run your finger down, make sure they're seated well. Everything's clean, good to go. Small correction. I think it's going to work out much easier this way. When you put the sensors in, put the O-ring on the sensor first. Because I was trying to push through the O-ring and it was really hard to push through. But with the O-ring already there, it should be much easier. And clean out the surface underneath there too, you know. I'm going to assume people are doing this anyway, but if you're not, whenever you take a bolt out, get a wire brush. Oops, wrong hand. Get a wire brush. And, well, obviously I'd be doing it with both hands, but clean the grooves off. Make them nice and clean. Get them off. Might as well do it. Now, I think I read somewhere that the torque for those is 17 foot-pounds. I'm not sure. I give it a good tightening. You don't have to worry as much. See those metal rings? They go right through. It keeps you from cracking them by over-tightening them. I don't go oomphing on it or anything, but I did a good, strong my hand. Good strong my hand and thumb, and that should be fine. You really don't want to leak down there, because then you got to take everything apart to get at it again, and that's no fun. So either look it up and be sure, or be confident enough to know that you've got it tight enough to not have to worry about it. So there you go. Now it's just a matter of putting everything back. Probably the only thing you need to make sure you know about is when these sensors go back in, those rings hang out on top here. So you might have to push down while you're putting the rings back on. So make sure that those are in, because if they're not, all over the place. So everything's and you're good to go. Obviously, fill your rad back up again, but other than that, hope you learned something. I did. It's the first time I've done this. But it's pretty basic. You just got to look at it first. get an idea of what you're getting into. Don't just attack it. Here we go. Everything's all together. Double check. Make sure everything that you took off is back. Make sure these, your clips are on both sides of the top of that. You're going to have to, as I said before, without damaging the wires, but you're going to have to put a finger and a thumb, oh, can we see this over there? Put a finger and thumb on top type thing. Push down with one hand and slide the clip in with the other. You're going to have to give it a pretty good oomph, but it'll get in there. You'll feel it. And then you can see, you probably can't hear, but you'll be able to see, you'll be able to see the clip sitting on top on both sides. Same with this one. So everything's back. Everything's good to go. Yeah. Ciao for now.